All right. Well, why am I starting with all right? It sounds weird. I mean, but it is all right.
It is all right.
Welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're going to be looking at the entire AI process using AML services, here with Parashar Shah. Did I say it right?
Yes.
Fantastic. How are you doing, my friend?
I'm doing well. How are you?
Good. Why don't you give us a little overview of what we're going to be talking about?
Okay, sure. So today I'm going to talk about the Azure Machine Learning Services, which are currently in public preview. And we are going to walk through an entire experiment where we are going to predict the income of a particular person based where you provide inputs based on the US government census data. We are going to use a classical machine learning approach, but the idea is to showcase that, okay, how powerful our Azure Machine Learning Services are and what can you do with it.
Fantastic. So this is a soup to nuts. Fantastic. So this is a soup to nuts from beginning to end, all of our AML, Azure ML services, how you use them, why you would use them, and what we can provide.
Perfect, yes.
Fantastic. All right, let's see what we got.
Okay, so let's start with the Microsoft AI platform, basically. So in the Microsoft AI platform has, if I can say, there are three particular components to it. One is the AI services, the other is the AI infrastructure, and the third part is the AI tools. Now, we have tried to see that, okay, different needs from different customers, everything can be satisfied. So the AI services allow you to use our PaaS-based services, be it in terms of the cognitive services, the APIs like custom visions, speech, and things like that. Or if you want to create bots, then you can use the bot framework and things like that. And the third part is the custom machine learning. So a lot of enterprises or customers would want to create their own machine learning model and then deploy it in cloud or on-prem. So that's what we call as Azure Machine Learning Services, and that is what I'm going to talk to today.
Fantastic. And so we've got a bunch of things that if people don't want to build their own, they can use cognitive services. If they want to do conversational type things, it's bot framework.
Yes.
If you could focus on what we're going to be focusing on today, what are the elements of the AI platform that we're going to be talking about today?
Sure. So today I'm going to walk you through an actual demo where we are building an application and we are using a remote compute. So think of it this way, like data scientists, what they normally do is they train on a particular machine and they will start it with a sample data set, they will explore the data, and then they want to scale it out, because, and that's where the power of cloud comes in. Once they are happy with a particular machine learning model, they actually want to deploy it, and that would be another thing. So this would be the actual process I'll walk you through, that, okay, you train it you start training on your local machine, then actually scale it out using a data science virtual machine, which has a GPU. And then once you are happy with the model, then you deploy it in the cloud in a cluster.
I see. So this includes services for not only just like deploying it and having it on the cloud, but also for training and for how to actually run the entire experiment.
That's right.
Fantastic.
And the good thing is, like, you pay only based on your usage. So it would be the pricing would be similar to what you would pay for spinning up a regular virtual machine.
Awesome. So show us how to get started.
Perfect. So let's look at the AI development lifecycle and where does Azure Machine Learning Services. So anytime you want to create a machine learning based application, you would have your data somewhere. Now, either that data is coming in real time or it has been stored somewhere. So once you have that data, you want to actually start creating features out of it, right? Because that's what is needed for a machine learning experiment. So that is what we call is a data preparation part of it. And then once you have created those features, you want to create train a machine learning model on top of that. So that's the prep and the train part, and you can use different compute, different storage options in this. And then once you're happy with that, you actually create the model and you use it for some. So that is the area where Azure Machine Learning Services fits in. Okay, and let's look at the capabilities which are now there. So we already have an Azure Machine Learning Studio, as you know, it's been there from 2014. And then we got feedback from the customers that we want more, like we want to use different compute options, we want to use different frameworks, and that's where we launched our new capabilities in September during our Ignite event. So now, what we allow users is that, okay, whatever IDE you are using, whatever framework you are using, you can use that. You can train your model, and then once you're ready, you can deploy it, be it in the cloud, you can even deploy it on-prem, or you can even deploy it on IoT edge.
So there's just a lot more options on what do you want to do, we can help you with that.
That's right, a lot of flexibility. So now, in the demo, what I'm going to walk you through is that this entire process of how you would actually use a Jupyter notebook and then deploy, train it using a DSN, like I said, and then deploy it in the cloud.
So all right, so let's start from the very beginning. Let's just say first time I'm looking at Azure ML and I want to start with this. How do you get the service started?
Sure. So for the setup part, we have any user would need at least three things to start. One is an experimentation account. Now, this experimentation account is actually maintaining all your run histories, because that is how normal data scientists would work, right? You would do multiple runs and try to figure out. So we maintain that run history. So anytime you want to go back in time and look at something, you can do that. The other thing is also attaching different remote compute targets. So you could use, like I said, a single vertical machine like a data science VM, or you could even scale it out with Spark-based, so HD inside Spark or something like that. The other part is the model management part. So once you have the model, you can actually deploy it, and that is the model management part. So you have to create these two. You could use the portal or you could use the CLI. And the third thing you would need is to actually install an IDE. Now, the IDE part is optional, whatever I'm going to show you, because you could use even your IDE and still use these two.
Or like Visual Studio Code has tools for
perfect.
AI that does
that's right, that's what we have, yeah. So let's go to the portal right now. And I already have the screen loaded, but essentially the way you would do it is just do a create resource, then select the AI plus cognitive services. And once you are in there, you can see on the top, we have the experimentation service and model management. Now, this is normally a one-time thing. So it's not that a data scientist would need to do that. So it could be like the account admin could set it up once, and then it could be shared by multiple data scientists.
And the reason why you would have an experimentation service is, for example, let's just say you're trying to figure out hyperparameters for a particular model. If you use the experimentation service right, you'd be able to see the history of what you've already tried. So that if Sally, data scientist, comes in, she won't be trying what Bob did a year ago and it didn't work. And it's just a way of keeping track of the work that has happened with the modeling.
That's right.
Fantastic. Yeah. And yeah. So the way you set it up is just like anything else on Azure?
That's right, yeah. You just provide the name, select the subscription, the resource group, and how many seats you have. So the first two seats are free, but if you want more, then you have to pay based on that, based on the contract you have. And then when you create the experimentation service, we give you the option to create the model management account right away. So you don't have to go to a separate page.
And again, the model management is to store the actual output of the training, which is the actual model. Let's just say it's the weights of a deep learning model, or the decision tree, or whatever, you know, let's just say you're using something else. It's just the numbers that you can do inferencing with.
That's right.
Okay.
So that's the particular HTTP API, which you can invoke in an application or wherever you want to.
I see. So experimentation is for when you're trying to figure out the best model. Model management is for when you have you have a model or maybe multiple models, and then that model gets better because the data gets out of date or stale model, and you can just use the model manager for that.
Yes, and track everything, like how many requests are coming, how many responses you are getting.
Awesome, and then the third thing you mentioned was the actual infrastructure where you run the experimentation, which is, let's just say you don't have a huge GPU or you want to be able to have a lot of RAM, for example. So that's when you would use like a data science VM to run that stuff in.
That's right, and probably I can show it to you right now itself. So you just select data science. And we provide you multiple options. In this case, you can pick up Linux. It comes pre-installed with all the frameworks and libraries. And then you are charged based on the type of compute you select. So you can associate a GPU or CPU. Whatever.
So this, the purpose of the data science VM is because, I don't know about you, but when I set up my environment for doing machine learning or data science the first time, I'm like installing a ton of things. And then, like, if I forget what I installed, and on the target machine that's doing the inferencing, it's not there. This creates a standard environment where everything can happen.
That's right. Okay. That's right. And we have tested all the interoperability of the libraries and made it easy for you.
Fantastic. So that's the setup. Is there anything else you need to do to get everything going?
No, not for this, except that, like I said, you could use your own ID or you could install our ID, which comes with the Azure Machine Learning Workbench.
Fantastic. So this, again, is just a really quick overview of what you do in the data science process, how we can help, what services we talked about, three, experimentation, model management, and DSVMs, data science VMs if you want to set those up. I honestly, like, I don't know how you couldn't use something like an experimentation service and have models that come out better every time. Like, there's no way to do that. And I love the idea of actually keeping track of all of the models that you have and making sure that if a model goes stale, that you put another one up there and then the services sort of catch up with that.
Yes, yes.
Awesome, so setup is pretty easy.
Yes.
Awesome, so in the next installment of this, we're gonna be talking about, once you have all that set up, what do you actually do? Does that work?
Yes.
All right, we'll see you then.